everyone, welcome back. So today's video, I'll be starting off by talking about myself. Well, I'm a final year undergraduate BSc Accounting with Economics student studying in University of Essex. I'll be starting my final year in October. And currently, I'm doing a part-time job in Essex Business School. Too much about me. Now coming to the main topic, that is university in UK. So, university's education system in UK is different as compared to India, in the sense that the amount of teaching hours is totally different. You'll have a lot of free time in UK compared to in India, where you have continuous classes from morning till evening. But in UK, you'll have a lot of free time. For example, my timetable, so I only have 2 hour lectures per day or 1 hour seminar class per day. The maximum busiest day I had was only 2 hour lecture in the morning, a 1 hour seminar, or a 2 hour lecture again in the afternoon. That's all. So you will have a lot of free time, and please do utilize it properly. How to utilize the free time? You can look for a part-time job, do volunteering, join societies, socialize with your friends, and there are many more that university offer. Please do take advantage of this opportunity and use these opportunities to gain more skills. So if you're looking for applying for a job after you graduate, most employees look at what skills you have gained. So it's important to utilize your free time properly. To keep myself busy during the free time by looking for part-time jobs, volunteering off campus, and also I joined few societies. And yes, I used to also study at the same time. I would recommend to study more frequently because the lecturers only provide you with PowerPoint slides and they do not contain all the information needed. So you will have to borrow the textbooks from the library. I would recommend to do it at the starting of the year as soon as the lecturer says which textbooks are needed for those courses you're studying. Or you can even buy second-hand books from your seniors because buying new books is expensive in UK. You'll only have 2 hour lecture and a 1 hour seminar class per module or subject. So you will have to study on your own. You will have to study a lot. If you have doubts, the lecturers and the class teachers of your seminars will be available in their office hours. Yeah, since you only get 3 hours of teaching time per module or subject, so I would strongly recommend you all to attend your lectures and seminars because they are very important. If you do not attend any, you might not understand it. That's pretty much about the education. Well, now coming to the services available in university, there's a students union which will help you in gaining extracurricular activities, and if you have any problem, you can always visit them in regards to your education or extracurricular activities or your health, well-being, if you feel homesick, whatsoever. There's SU advice, students union advice, which will help you in dealing with all these problems. If you have any problems with regarding the university, like example, your fees or accommodation and stuff like that, you can always visit the student center. But in my university, there's employability center where they help you with your CV, cover letter, finding part-time jobs, and also with your application process. So you can always visit them if you need any help. There's a healthcare on campus where they treat you for free. And yeah, this is pretty much the main services available on campus. But as you go along your studies, there are more opportunities that become available. So please do take advantage of it to gain more skills. And there are many eating places on campus where you can buy food. And lastly, I would recommend you all to join groups WhatsApp or Facebook group before joining the university, as it would help you to get to know more about the university, about your course, make new friends, get to know about your accommodation details and places nearby, how to arrive to the campus, how to get settled in. Well, these groups will be useful for you to help you get settled in into the university. Well, I guess this is how the most universities in UK are, as my university gives us a 1 month of December break and 1 month of spring break in March. And yes, the Students' Union organizes trips to and fro London for free. Please do take part in it and utilize this free time to explore UK. And also, there will be many events happening throughout the year, so you can participate for free and enjoy, get rid of your boredom. This is pretty much about the universities. I hope you found this video useful and you enjoyed it. So please do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. See you soon.